out my nana crib, cause grandma had an open door. Call my nigga slipping, pray where we he supposed to go. That 40 smoke, spirit still floating by the corner stove. Made the fiend try it, nigga overdose like comatose. We shoot things dirty on the drill, shit was too clean. Front pack, crazy, Keon died with his hoop dreams. Used to look up to him, now I gotta look up to him. Since I'm off the trauma unit, need support to hook up to him. Pray, don't need no money for them demons to slide. I seen the preacher cop some coke, I stopped believing in God. If you ain't never seen no brain, you shouldn't be in this ride. We why they wanna raise their kids, we gave them reason to hide. I swear to God, I swear to God.
Listen, man, having kids, man, this shit don't come with no booklet. This shit don't come with no manual. Like, you think you're going to get sleep, my nigga, and then it's just like Dub City.
Oh, nah, you got infants, my man. Niggas, you ain't getting no sleep for a while.
They was acting like they was at a Travis Scott fucking concert. These niggas was screaming their heads off.
Mm-hmm.
It was acting crazy, man. All right, yo, let's get into the shits, though. Yo, welcome to New Era Podcast. Just, you know what I mean? Just the guys talking they bullshit. It's your boy Ben Swayze, most hated, even though they love him. Catch me at an event near you. You know what I mean? More deck. We got my guy Dutch. What up, Dutch?
Hey, what's going on, y'all? Dutch KIB, man. What's going on? Keep it a buck. You know the vibes on this side.
Heard you got the AC on?
Not yet. It ain't get hot yet. It's gonna get hot yet. Though. It's gonna get hot though.
About, man, we got my guy, Lil Freddy. What up, Fred?
Lil Freddy, man, drop the TV. Sell about Freddy, all that good shit.
Yes, sir. All right, man. And then we got this nigga here. I had to pull him up last, man, because he getting me angry already. Fat boy, what up, boy?
Nigga gonna try to introduce me last because I got a new mic hating ass nigga.
I don't like the way your mic sound, bro. You sound like the Terminator.
What you mean? I sound like the Terminator.
My nigga, you sound like you choking underwater.
It feel like it, too. This shit crazy, bro.
Yeah, it
sounds like you need to bring that back to Best Buy. That's what it sound like.
It sound like you got them fucking, Verbal Warzone, the Verbal Warzone headsets.
Call of Duty joints.
Yeah. They got the Mitsubishi headset, the Mitsubishi.
The Bobby Brown shits, man.
Let
Fat Boy live.
Tickets packed him up early.
Hashi-tashi.
All
right, man. Yesterday, though, y'all know where y'all here, man. Yesterday was Ultimate Madness Round 2.
The new season of URL's Ultimate Madness premieres live on Caffeine. Watch as 16 skilled competitors put it all on the line. The two finalists will be battling at one of the culture's most important events, URL's Dome 10.
Thanks.
How we feeling, guys? How we feeling? We're going to do how we always do. We start with you. No, we started with Dutch last time. Freddie, out of rating out of 10, what you gave this week's battles?
I would put them around a 7. Was a little more excited. I thought we were going to get some better battles. I would say it's kind of like the first week where we got like 2 out of 4. You feel me? One really fire one. Good one. And then 2 like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, we'll get into it. I was at about a 7 out of 10, though.
Yeah, I agree with you. I feel like it's always split even. Like, you always get half the battles is good and half the battles is bad. When actually, all the fucking battles need to be good, man. Like, I don't...
Yeah,
we're going to get into this shit. But I gave it like a 7, too. I agree with you. I gave it like a 7. What you gave it, Dutch?
Yo, you... I'm back on. All right, cool. All right, on a scale of 1 to 10, I think I gave it like a 7 last time. Mm-hmm. I'm going to have to give this maybe like a 6.5.
6.5?
No, Dutch didn't really move.
Dutch is
really
like the Dwayne Wade of judging, bro. Like, this nigga do not give out high numbers, bro. Like,
bro, like, nah, like, I bet we started the day off with Fonz and Easy.
Hold on. We not gonna get into the battles yet. You about to give his recap in the first 5 minutes. Like,
I'm not. What my point is, just to sum it up, you know what I'm saying? Like, it started off good, and then as the night went on, it was like, oh my god.
But then it ended good. It started good and ended good.
It ended decent. It ended on a good note. I put it like that. Ended on a good note. That's good. You know what I'm saying?
To be fair, Dutch kind of said that going into it last week. I think he wasn't too excited about all the battles. So.
Dutch ain't never excited, fact. Bro. It's hard to get this. It's hard to get these fat niggas excited. Pause.
But I hear you though.
Yo, that's beyond the pause, my nigga. Just never say that shit again. Don't ever say get fat niggas excited. Don't ever say that again, bro.
Yo, fat boy, what you gave the shit out of
right
time?
Right out the gate, it's a four. It's a four.
Oh shit, this nigga's violating. Nah, we're not doing that, bro. It wasn't a four.
It was a four.
I'm getting straight to the something. Don DeMarco. Listen, I'm on 1,000, my nigga. The shitty ass performance we got out of two of them battles is what dragged this shit all the way down for me. Like, we started off
talk hot, about it,
and they had a cold, that's like a fucking hot pocket with the cheese cold in the middle. And then when you get to the end, it was warm a little bit. We ain't doing that, bro. This shit was ass. It was a four, my nigga.
Nah, yo. Keep it up. No. Don't try to blame it on the niggas that was trash. You giving it a four because your man lost.
That ain't got nothing to do with it.
Bro, you giving it a four because your man lost. That's exactly what it got to do with it,
bro. Hey, bro, I'm going to keep it 1,000. Listen, we started off with a fire first battle, right? And then the next two shits, they was hard to get through, bro. I was struggling to keep my interest in them battles. They were so fucking bad. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. And I had to convince myself to stay locked in for this last battle, bro. I almost checked the fuck out by the time we got to that third battle. Like, jeez, this shit is ass.
Four out of ten.
Shit was bad, yo.
I drink to that. God damn it.
This was bad, yo.
Well, okay. I ain't mad at you for that. Let's get into it, man. First battle of the night. They said it's going to be one of them ones. Fonz versus Easy to Block Captain. Henny man in the building, I see you, Brody. Easy to Block Captain versus Fonz. How we out feeling about that battle out the gate, man? Like, is it one of the best battles of the tournament? Definitely one of the night. How we feeling, y'all?
Personal best battle of the tournament to me. You know what I'm saying? I ain't going to say clear, but it's the best in terms of the content, in terms of the intensity. You understand? Nice contrast. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's my personal, you know what I'm saying, favorite.
I can agree. It's up there. I would say top 3 to 4 battles for sure. You know what I'm saying? I probably want to watch them a few times, but this was up there. This was a fire back and forth.
Yeah. I watched the replay real quick while I was doing dishes and all that. And, bruh, that battle was fire, yo. And it's going to get real controversial when that shit re-drop, bro, because, like, I have Fonz winning not clearly, but pretty clearly. And on that rewatch, bro, that nigga Easy was spitting some pain, yo. Like,
I was going to say the same shit. It's a lot closer on the second watch, bro.
It's a lot closer, yo. Fatboy, how you feeling about the battle overall?
You already know how I feel. Niggas already know what time it is. And I'm glad this was the first battle so we can start with this battle.
You hauling mad?
Oh! Nigga, I'm Baltimore, man. This is some other shit right here, boy. Listen, I'm going to start off like this. The battle in its entirety was great. It was a fire battle. I want to first say salute the Fonz before I get the packing shit the fuck up. Salute the Fonz. You brought this shit. You deservedly won the battle simply because it was close. So I'm not mad at niggas giving you the battle. I'm not mad that he got the win. This is what I'm mad at, bro. I'm mad at all four judges making it a clean sweep and the fans clearly picking Easy to win the battle.
It's kind of crazy.
I'm mad at that part of it, and I'm mad at the fact that nobody, not one fucking judge, brought up the fact.
Are they slipping and all that? Stumbling?
Not one of you niggas pointed out the fact that this nigga Fonz had two different stumbles in that second round
And his second wasn't that crazy.
Nah, don't do that.
I don't agree. I don't agree with that.
Don't do that, bro.
It wasn't that
his
crazy.
His second was crazy, bro.
Did in that second. Yeah. Nah, I'm not doing that, bro. I had Easy clearly taking the first to me. I had Easy taking the first round.
Right.
And Fonz tried to turn that shit up in the second. And it just went, it wasn't all the way
he
there.
Did.
He was on his shit.
Hold on, wait, stop.
Nah, he turned
up in a second. I don't
he
think
he turned up.
Nah, he didn't in a second.
Yeah, he did.
He tried to go a little higher than what he did in the first episode. What Easy bro. Did. And he like did Easy. Not meet expectation in that second, bro. I'm not gonna hold you.
I feel like Easy snatched the second. I feel like Easy snatched the momentum of the first round and then he tried to. What really happened in the second, Easy wasn't as good as his other
rounds. Yeah, Easy wasn't that. Nah, Easy was crazy in the second, too, though.
He wasn't. Nah. He wasn't as good as his other rounds. He wasn't
Easy
as good.
The,
it wasn't,
the
that
tat
was
on my arm
round.
And snitching, but just crazy with a tattletale.
That was his third.
Nah, that was the second.
Oh, all right.
The second had the pawn and the queen thing and the landlord. That was
He brought the bullshit. He brought that shit back. Like, his second was dope.
Fun's second was crazy, too, though. That with this cock-a-doodle-doo. Like,
That was in his third.
I be getting the rounds mixed up, bro. I gotta
rewatch
that.
Second, though,
shit.
He had the if you went to jello pussy, you coming out that same pussy like a sibling. Like, yeah, he
was the sibling ball. He had the rubbing in your ribs. I'm two seasoned.
That was crazy.
OG Bobby Johnson, you came home to smack me, fucking
your
bitch.
Like, that was crazy. Man.
His second was crazy, fat boy. Both of them.
Was Easy with the I came back with two raises, the cell phone shit. That was the second or third.
That was the first, I think.
I wrote all this down.
Mm-hmm. Bro, I couldn't write that down, incredible. Bro. I was
Easy's first might be round of the battle. I ain't gonna front. Like, he came out the gate wigging and he out bar Fonz.
I ain't gonna lie though.
He talked to that nigga, bro.
It came down to the third. Don't do that, bro. It was 1-1 going into the third.
I understand the stumbling, but
the stumbling wasn't like the Mr. Stumbler, which we're gonna get into. It wasn't Mr. Stumbler, bro.
No, hold on. This is what we not doing. We not about to sit here as fans who've been watching this shit forever and start picking and choosing which stumbles is good and
it
which
is. Ain't. Nah, but Fat Boy, it is, bro. It's a difference between stumbling throughout your whole round and it's a difference between
Not clear rounds is not clean rounds. I'm sorry.
If you tripping over your words, bro, niggas is gonna trip over a couple words. Like, you might have said a word wrong a little bit. That's not the same as you just stumbling.
Yeah, true.
Bro, don't do that, bro. You being overcritical right now. You being overcritical.
Bro, I can see if you did it once, but the nigga did it twice. And that's your perception of the stumble. To me, I feel like the second stumble was worse than the first towards the end of his second round. I'm not saying that was the end all be all to him losing the round. I'm saying my nigga Easy had a good fucking second round.
Absolutely,
and his shit was clean.
But let me ask you this:
his second round was good. It wasn't clean.
Let me ask you this: Easy said that Fonz won the second. Easy said that. So then now, what do we say to that?
But I ain't Easy. I'm telling you that.
That's a fact.
Nah, we not doing. All right.
I seen.
Danny Myers, perfect example. Danny Myers versus Franchise. Danny gave Franchise the second. Even though all the fans said Danny won the battle because he won the first two. He said, I feel
that's
like.
That's what happened.
That is
I
what
think Danny gave him the battle on camera. I think
if nigga that was battling feel like he lost that round, who are we to say, you really did win? If you feel in your heart of hearts that you even lost. What are you talking about?
That's who say. That's not what happened anyway.
That is what happened.
Smack gave Franchise that round and said it was 1-1. It wasn't fucking Danny. So let's get that shit straight.
Danny said it in the interview. What are you talking about?
It was in an interview, Fat Boy. It was in an interview.
My nigga, Smack said, all right, it's 1-1. And fucking Danny coached.
No, we're talking about after.
He did it in the interview, but he did it during the battle, bro.
Both of y'all are right.
During the battle.
Both of y'all are right. How are we both going
to
be right?
Because that did happen in the battle for sure, but. Danny
right, it was 1-1. Let's get to the third round. It was 1-1. Mm-hmm. You could try to. It was 1-1 going into the third round, bro.
Not
pack
in my
it up.
Opinion.
Again,
not in my
again
opinion,
for the sake of argument, I'm going to just leave it like this, bro. I can see where nigga, like I said, I can see where niggas got Fonz winning the battle. Cool. I'm not mad. Cool. He earned it, yo. He put on a great fucking performance. I don't want to take away from it at all. But what I will say in judging it, to me, I had it 2-0 going into the third.
Yo, okay.
That's how I yo, had it.
All right. Let's say you had it 2-0 going into the third, right?
The fans fucking agreed, damn near. The fans fucking
nobody
agreed
to that, bro. Nobody agreed to that.
Bro.
And that fans.
Bro,
and that
I was watching the chat, bro. Everybody was saying 1-1 going into
so
the third.
So why people was clicking on that easy button? You know what I'm saying?
That's true.
Yeah, it got yeah, son. Like,
bro, I ain't gonna hold you. I clicked on both their names. Like, I'm just keeping it 100. I did. I'm keeping it 100. But I think the third round, right? This is why Easy lost the third. You know what I'm saying? I feel like he started off kind of slow, bro. Like it took him a little minute to heat up. He started off slow. He ended the shit wild, like, you know what I mean? He ended wild strong. Like the whole my bitch the shooter. I mean, my bitch the driver. I'm the shooter. What you gonna do with the DU and I? That whole like setup, that was crazy. That was a way better ending than Fonz ending. But that Hurricane dude,
Fonz is good pretty much throughout the whole third though, where Easy kind of just heated up towards the end.
Nah, like I put with the third round, right? I feel like both of them started slow. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So at the end of the day, it's really a preference on content and whatever. You know what I'm saying? Because Fonz's third going into the end of the round was wild. Bro, the bone in the flesh bar.
That was in the third. That was in the third, son.
Big Bad Wolf. Rams in the closet. Come on, son.
Yo, Beats Go.
Murder, She Wrote, Typewriter.
Yeah,
son,
yeah,
he was Fonz was blacking in that third.
They put you
son.
In front of this typewriter, and that was Murder, She Wrote. That was crazy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nah, I'm not gonna hold you, bro. It's gonna be a lot more debatable on the rewatch, but Fonz won that, yo. Like easy. Yeah. It's preference too, yo. Like not for nothing. The shit is kind of preference, cause Easy that nigga be saying shit that give you chills, B. Like that nigga be really talking like. But he I have Fonz winning, bro. I had Fonz winning the first and the third.
Easy made me a fan. I ain't gonna cap. Like I wasn't too super high fan. Of Easy, but man,
I'm a super fan.
I'm looking forward to the future of Easy, the block captain. Like he's fire. And for him to say that he's not really bar heavy, like he had bars. Like he had bars. For him to say that, I don't see that. He had bars against Fonz. Yo, that, what do you say? The information on the arm. Out. What do you say? Oh, that shit was crazy. The information on the arm, quarterback shit. That's crazy.
Yo, I'm not gonna hold you, bro. Like it seems like every week I keep saying that this is my favorite battle, yo. This might be my favorite battle of the tournament so far, yo. Easy and Fonz. No funny shit, bro. Like trust me, bro, Kid Chaos and Jada Nightwing, I like what they were saying. I like that shit. Fucking Jada Nightwing versus Real Sick. Castro. I like that. Mm-hmm. Real Sick, I like that. Mm-hmm. Kid Chaos versus Luke Castro, I like that. Chaos versus Real Sick. I like that battle. But this battle right here, bro, it just hit a little bit different. Like, it was like, it was the type of shit that I like in battles. You know what I'm saying? Like, when I watched Ill Will versus Calico, that's why I had that battle 2 years ago being Battle of the Year. Like, I like that type of shit that they was talking, bro. Like, them niggas was talking a shit, bro. Like, they brought that, they had a certain type of talk that nobody, that I guess other people in the battle could talk that shit. Like Ace and Brooklyn Hands, like they street niggas, but they can't articulate it in a battle type of way. Like, yeah, they can't execute it the same.
How do y'all feel about Fonz bringing that energy off top with the little bump?
The bumps and all that. I loved it. Yo, bro, I ain't gonna hold you, bro. If this battle was on the main stage, yo, this was like the opening to imagine this being the opening to Gnome in Houston. Bro,
shit would have went crazy.
Bro, bullshit. Bullshit. I ain't gonna lie.
Doing that
shit is fire too, bro. Even that little shit like that. Fat boy,
yeah,
I know you.
The crowd would have chimed in with them bullshits. They would have started yelling that shit too.
Yeah.
That shit would have got crazy, bro.
That would have got crazy.
After watching it back, though, I'm not even mad at Fat Boy having Easy. Like, it's close. It's even closer on the watch back.
It's the reason why he's saying it. I don't want the perception to be, oh no, Easy won because Fonz slipped up. Like, we not doing that. Just say, yo, I liked his material better.
No, you can't do that. Don't want the perception. My nigga, this my perception. This was the battle. The nigga stumbled twice.
Bruh.
So wait, Fat Boy.
Let me ask you a question. Like Ben was saying, because Fonz stumbled twice, you have to give Easy the battle, or was Easy better than Fonz?
No, because I'm not that type of fan. What I'm saying is this: if you deduct points for a stumble, rounds clean. Which one did and which one didn't? If it's that fucking close.
I get what you're saying.
So I'm saying I deducted points for two separate stumbles, and my nigga got through his round clean. Y'all saying it was close, right?
Okay, I'm asking you.
I don't think the second was that close, bro. I don't think the second was that close.
So you saying that to
measure it on a stumble,
and the stumbles didn't matter.
I think the third round was closer than the second round.
No, you're not answering my question. I said, you said the second round was close and the stumbles don't matter.
I didn't say it don't matter, bro. I'm saying that.
So what you saying?
I don't think they took enough points off for.
Yeah, it's not like I'm not round. Right, like not for me to be like, oh, it's not like it's a knockdown. Like you stumble, so it's a knockdown. Now if you stumbling all throughout the fucking battle and I can't understand what you're saying, that's a whole different thing. Rather than you stumbling over some words that you said, you might have said,
If I watch a round,
you might have said this is fire instead of saying that is fire, and then it's like you stumble over, you got to bring it back a little bit.
I think what Fat Boy is saying, niggas is nitpicking. You know what I'm saying?
Fat Boy is nitpicking. That's what's going on.
What I'm saying is that, meaning nitpicking, pretty much what I'm saying is that people are making the argument when it fits their argument. You know what I'm saying? Right. Like, boom. Perfect example.
Nobody said it.
A stumbled in the second round versus Bad News, right?
Is there a round to Bad News, right?
Shout out to Big Hand. He literally said this when we interviewed him the other day, and a nigga said, niggas is picking and choosing when it fit their narrative. That's exactly what he said. Mm-hmm. And nobody mentioned the stumbles, and for everybody to be saying how close that second was, nobody seemed to give a fuck that he stumbled twice. I'm not saying he should have won the battle. Again, salute to that man. He won. Congratulations. I'm not mad. I'm looking forward to his next battle. What I'm saying is, for me, for Fat Boy, when you had to judge this battle and I had to go, damn, this round was close as shit. It's that fucking close, like Rage's ads close. The nigga that got through his round clean was Easy. Period. Mm. That's all I'm saying. So when it came down to me picking, that's the direction I went. If I had to cut it with a knife, that's which way I'm going with it. That's okay. It.
I'm not mad.
Listen, man. Heard you, bro. Like, at the end of the day, bro, I don't think the second was close. I'm keeping it. That's just my opinion. I don't think the second was close. I think you're making it more close right now in your debate than what the fuck I actually watched. What I watched was Fonz fucking snapping in that second. And Easy had some shit. Easy was going off, but Fonz was fucking snapping in the second round, bro. And you sitting here trying to tell me now that all of a sudden this shit is like it's neck and neck. The battle is right there. He won by like a splitting edge, and the stumbling should have took it away from him. Nah, I'm not doing
that.
Wait, Henny, man. What round you saying? Because Henny man was saying Easy wasn't getting his shit out clear either.
He stumbled, but it wasn't clean.
So which rounds was that, Henny man? The second. He was live in the building.
What'd he say?
He said that Easy wasn't clean either
in that second.
I didn't hear no stumbles. If he heard it, he saw something I ain't see.
Easy said it. Okay. He lost momentum towards the end of his second. I agree.
Hey, why Ben trying to sit up here and convince niggas that second wasn't close?
I don't gotta convince nobody nothing, nigga. The judges picked who they picked.
Hey, that's cool. While you trying to tell niggas the second wasn't close and Fonz won the third, okay, so how the fuck did these niggas pick Easy to win the whole fucking battle by the fan vote? So what rounds they give this nigga then?
Bro, I just told you, bro. I voted for both of them. Who the fuck can't? Yo, bro, I didn't want to do this, bro, but since you want to take it there, bro. Yo, that fan vote shit, all that shit, pack that shit up anyway, my nigga. Like, let's keep it a whole band, though, yo. That whole fan vote shit is all fucked up. That shit is all fucked up. It's all fucked up, bro.
Hey, Big Hand, you was right, my nigga. These niggas love to fit their narrative, bro.
Don't throw big hand in this. Don't throw big hand in this. Cause that's like this ain't the same energy. No. This the same energy. This is not the same energy you had with Bad News versus Ace Amin. When niggas was saying Ace Amin was stumbling all through his rounds versus Bad News, you ain't have shit to say about that thing. Then it was, yo, but his material was better than Bad News.
Yo, who ain't been listening to this show know that I don't give a fuck what happened to Bad News Battles, bro.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. You proving your own point, bro. You sitting here painting a certain narrative, talking about some, yo, niggas want to pick who they want to pick when it fits their narrative. But when Ace Amin did the same exact shit versus Bad News, stumbled all through his shit on his fucking Boomhauer shit, like King of the Hill, you ain't have shit to say then.
Where was your energy at to defend that shit then? Because I ain't hear you say shit.
Because, my nigga, when it's all said and done, bro, whoever won, won. No. And I did have this energy.
You had to defend it when it happened.
Time. All right. Let's move on, man. Nigga,
shout out to them. I'm on vacation. So
I'm pulling up. What's the Addy, bro? What's the motherfucking Addy, my nigga? We ain't doing that, bro.
Yo,
sick of this shit.
Yo, that battle got wild replay value though, man. Like,
shout out to them.
I'm watching that shit as soon as this shit is over. I'm watching that battle again. As soon as this whole shit is over, this whole fucking like episode, I'm about to rewatch that shit again.
Hey, and when you do, don't come back and tell me Easy won because I don't want to hear that shit.
I can't change my pick.
No, hell no, stay over there, my nigga. Stay on that side.
That's crazy, bro. Yeah, that's crazy, bro. This ain't me versus Easy, bro. Bro, this ain't me versus Easy the Block Captain, bro. I like Easy. Like, I fucks with him. OD.
The ops right now, my nigga. I ain't with that shit.
All right, moving along.
Come up. Stay over there.
Can we move along now, bro? Can we move along? All right,
we
can
go ahead. All right.
Next battle, we had... Oh, my God, yo.
We had Trey.
I gotta ask a question.
Yeah, but I feel like I'm gonna win. I don't take it.
Why is that though?
Because I'm not playing, bro.
Okay.
They said I played last time, right?
That's what they said in the comments right there. Right. Go there and list. Right. They said you playing.
They said I played last time, right? Indeed. Now what happens when I don't? Bro, shit real.
Yeah.
I'm afraid he might need a crowd. I'm not so sure he can. You know.
You think he needs a crowd?
At first I didn't. I thought this would be beneficial for the writer niggas, but as I'm starting to see, like. Homie might need a crowd, you know what I'm saying?
You won by default.
That's how you feel?
He got a point. The nigga did.
He said he got a point. Like, so you think you won by default?
Well, I forgot.
Icy hot. Alexa.
Oscar. Where you at, Oscar?
Yo, next battle, bro, we have Oscar the Grouch versus...
The Cookie Monster.
We got Oscar the Grouch versus the fucking Cookie Monster.
Oh, I love trash. Anything dirty or dingy or dusty. Anything ragged or rotten or rusty. Yes, I love trash.
Yo, let me say something real quick. Niggas is foul in that chat, son. Why they gotta do my man Rue Bandle like that, saying that he got a personality of a wall?
Yo,
like,
straight up, bro.
Yo, bro, I'm not gonna hold you, bro. I feel like texting this nigga right now and telling this nigga to pull up to the fucking show, yo. Like, cause this nigga Bandle, bro. Yo. But nah, I don't wanna do it, yo. That shit gonna dry the fucking show up. Like, I don't know, bro. Like, this nigga need to fucking. He gotta like.
I said that shit before. Like,
he gotta be more happy, man. Yeah, man. They gonna be too laid back. Like, but all right, going to the battle. All right, let me say the good parts of the battle. All right, I think that I liked in the first round. I like Giannis' energy in the first round. I think he had good energy in the first round. And
what the fuck was he talking about though, man?
Was it Rue Bandle's second or Rue Bandle's third? That he actually like kind of turned up a little bit.
His third round. He knew he won the battle when he knew all he had to do was get through his material.
Yeah.
Then he actually showed some fucking conviction. Like,
yo, Rue Bandle about to win this whole shit. Me watch. That nigga about to win the whole shit. Watch.
Yo, don't say that.
Man, Rue Bandle's on that load management shit, son. Like, that nigga's not sweating at all until the finals beat, and then. You know what I'm saying? It's over.
Well, that nigga about to run into LeBron next. Like, he on his fucking Toronto Raptors shit when they had DeMar Rosen. Yeah. And he about to run into LeBron, B. It's about to get quiet for that young man.
Now, you know what's making me nervous, Ben, saying Rubando gonna win this shit? His next opponent got Jay, Knight, and Wayne. That nigga can make mad flips out of that. That nigga would win this fucking battle.
Nah, he not
Jay
going
fucking
that,
choke
man.
Or some shit like or, that.
Yeah, or Jay could choke.
Like... Yeah, I'm gonna be mad as shit. Like, man, don't do this.
And the pressure is going to be even more on Jay to not choke. That's
this
like,
shit blowing minds, man. I wanted to see Rubando versus Brooklyn Hands, man. That was my dream matchup, yo.
Brooklyn all day, you heard?
Oh, so, my. Hey,
that shit was about to be wild domestic. Yo.
Nigga
about to hang that nigga from a balcony.
What was Honor talking about, though? He was
talking about being his
parent, feeding him Flintstone gummies and
nigga
shit.
Said,
like, what are you talking
to
about?
His chest like a pizza boy.
What did that even mean?
There's 8 slices in a pizza pie.
Oh my god!
Nigga said that. He said, "Nigga, that shirt ugly as hell."
Big Low in the chat. We need some Michigan confirmation so we can get the breakdown on this Michigan Fab Five.
Yeah, I don't know, yo, bro.
Like,
he was like, "You ever seen the Fab Five? You ever seen the Fab Five? Nigga, that what happened was weird. Chris Webber called the timeout, and I'm like, yo, bro, what the fuck is this nigga talking about?
That like, was weird. Like, what are you talking
five,
about, bro?
Five incoming freshmen.
Yo,
then,
bro.
Then he talking about what he going to do with the money. And like, come on, bro. Go ahead, Fatboy.
Yo, he said, yeah, because I'm a bracket buster. My nigga, you sold us all that last minute material to tell us you a bracket buster. Get the fuck off my line with that.
Yo, bro. Yo, bro. He had a RuPaul bar, son. He called that. He called Bando RuPaul.
Got him. Got him. Oh.
And Honor was talking about some 30 dangling and some pause-worthy shit. Like, what are you talking about?
The part when he started the third round,
when he had the Kawhi Leonard laugh. You remember that?
Yo. He couldn't find his phone. He was sweating bullets.
Hold on, we gotta keep it a thousand, yo. Alright, I'm gonna be real. In the first round, I felt like Yana did get the first round. I don't feel like he was too bad, but he wasn't good. He just wasn't too bad. And Rubando, I felt like Yana got the first, but then when it hit that second, and this nigga Yana just started going off into the galaxy with his fucking material. I don't know what he was doing. And I edged the second to Rubando. And then the chokes. I mean, it just was a bad battle.
Yo, niggas got me crying right now, bro.
The tournament was making this second battle even worse.
This nigga Freddy.
The first battle was so good.
Yo, this nigga Freddy said that the nigga couldn't find his phone. Nigga was panicking.
Sweating bullets out there. Like,
yo, I can't stop laughing at that, yo. This nigga, yo. This nigga said, whatever yo, came to that nigga mind, that nigga just said that shit, yo. Nigga was saying anything, yo.
Nigga said, yo, my phone over there charging.
He might even reach for it still. Like, bro, it's not there, bro. Do something.
It's over there charging. He's charging right next to baby.
And then he was talking about breaking, what he would do with the money. He was talking about being a sneakerhead and named some weak ass sneakers. Patrick Ewins.
Nigga said he said the last 3,000s. I wanted the Patrick Ewins. I'm like,
yo, what? No Patrick Ewins slander over here. All right, Patrick Ewins slander.
Yo.
But the man said, yo, you look like you was being fed gummies and all that shit.
Yeah, I'm trying to be his parent. Like,
life
come up, bending them over and punting them. Like, what are you talking about, bro?
Yo, I'm gonna keep it real, yo. They got rookies, bro. They got rookies versus vets coming up, yo. Yo, bro, I want everybody to get an opportunity, yo, but some niggas, bro, just clearly is not ready. Like, unless y'all want same shit to happen with Real Deal and Snow, I don't know if niggas remember that battle, bro, but like,
oh man,
I haven't seen Snow since that battle, bro.
Somebody said Your Honor versus Clips. Don't ever disrespect Clips like that. Like, Clips will obliterate Your Honor, bro. Like, we ain't doing that. Your Honor got to get it together.
Clips is beating that nigga on 3 freestyle rounds. No prep, no nothing. He is watching, son.
Yo, let me say this real quick. Breaking news. Shout outs to Adamski. Cortez tweeted, no lie, no Hurricane do try setting it up before, but I have a lot of fun stopping Easy to block Captain Momentum and beating the shit out of him to make him greater in the future. And Easy replied, it would get bad for you.
Shut it the fuck up.
Easy, don't do it, because me and Fat Boy going to have about a 50 clip on the battle, and I don't want to take his money. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, so, yo. Let it happen. Let it happen.
Yeah, I like that on both ends.
Shout out
I
to Core, like yo. That nigga Core, yo, he really fuck with, like, he really be in tune with, like, the newer battlers and shit like that, and then, like, trying to get them, you know what I mean? Trying to set niggas up in right positions, bro, but Easy, chill out, man. It's different, bro. It's different, bro. It's different.
You know what's crazy? Is over a year ago, I was the first one telling niggas to go check out Easy to block. If you ain't getting in tune with this nigga yet, you missing out. And I'm just glad to see this nigga finally fucking flourishing and getting all his props, because that nigga, yo, he one of the ones, bro. He talked that shit. He really talk it, bro. It's that old Calico feel, the Geechee feel. Like, he give you something that, you know, when he start talking, he gonna give you some of that shit, bro. It's gonna be fire. And it's not a lot of MCs in this tournament that got that. It's just not. That's why we missed out on the true foes and the niggas that should be in this tournament. They would have changed this whole... This would have been a lot better tournament, bro.
Get Easy on the rooftop, too.
Entirely. Hell,
get Easy on the rooftop, too. Let them bring that pain to the rooftop.
Man, I want to see Easy versus Brooklyn Hands.
That's nice, too. I like that,
too. On the rooftop. I want to see Easy versus Brooklyn Hands on the roof.
I want a prepared Brooklyn Hands. In any battle you can make, please, just...
Perfect segue, huh?
Come on, man.
Perfect segue. Next battle... We had Lauren Hands versus Brooklyn Hill. The sneaky solid man, the punk domestic violence man, the quick to stop asking them, stop acting like boys and be men. How you
gonna win when you ain't right with them? Yo, you need to relax, man. We can't protect you, bro.
Shout outs to the JT.
You can't guarantee your safety, bro.
Yo, shout outs to the JT.
Not with that shit out, because I'm
Wait.
The miseducation of Brooklyn
Hill. She's in the chat. Oh, Rita, what made you say or put that analogy out there with Lauryn Hill and Brooklyn Hands?
Like, yo, like, listen,
what's the parallels? You know what I'm saying? Like,
yo, I'm gonna try, yo. I think that she was just basically trying to say that he's a poet. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like a poetic,
a ghetto poet. Type. You know what I'm saying? And like, that's the only way I could defend it. You know what I'm saying? But
when
I just think
that damn dangerous.
Yeah, I think she should have used a different poet, but I think that's just the first name that came to mind.
That was pretty bad.
She probably was cleaning the crib up and lit through on some Lauryn Hill or something while she was cleaning the crib, and that
sweetest
shit was just
thing it
was
I right ever there, know.
Bro. That shit was like comparing Styles P to Mariah Carey.
That's a classic.
I could kiss on a collarbone.
That shit was like comparing Coogi rap to motherfucking Beyonce. That
shit was Rita, you was drunk.
We feel you, Rita. We feel you.
Yo,
Rita,
two threes to the collarbone.
Two threes to the collarbone. Tactical hand knives with the switchblade. Yo,
gangster spoken word. I like
Rita. You and I would not ever let you live this down. Like,
yeah,
you
gonna catch this.
I hit you.
Yeah, you gonna catch these jokes forever for this one. Yo, I'm sorry, Rita. We love you, the big JT. You know what I mean? You the But you gotta get those jokes, man. You gotta catch those. Let's get into the battle, yo. Brooklyn Hands versus
Ace.
Versus Ace, I mean.
The shit was so bad he can't even remember who it was. Like, that's bad the battle was.
Yo.
Dog, this wasn't good, bro. Another battle where I just was struggling. Like, I don't even want to watch this no more, bro. That's where I was at by the time this battle was halfway through. And Ace started choking, and I was like, fam, I'm out, man. I'm just going to keep the screen up. We need photos. We need clips. I'm watching it for strictly this now. I don't even care what y'all say one day.
This nigga Ace, I mean, be sounding like fucking, he be sounding like Jack Jenkins from fucking Boomerang. Remember the fucking boxer? The nigga that just be stumbling and fucking all that shit, yo? I'm not going to hold you, bro. That nigga Ace, bro, I know he be saying, like, when he see me, it's going to be a problem and shit, bro. But you got to pack all that shit the fuck up, my nigga. All that stumbling and all that, bro. Niggas, and I get it. Niggas be like, yo, it was 2 weeks prep. My nigga, for a lot of people, that's a lot of time, my nigga. Like, and I don't know, bro. Like, the way Ace raps, bro, it's not, I don't know if it's built for this kind of tournament. Like, he be trying to say too many words, bro. Like,
but that's how he raps, though. I
mean, wait, what?
This nigga needs a fucking Twitter limit. Like, he need a word limit. Like, my nigga, you can't say this many words in a round, bro, because...
You saying that he don't get to the point quicker than the other people?
Nah, he just be saying too many words. Like, it just be too many words jumbled up together.
Sometimes it's no point neither. It's just a lot of words.
It's just mad words. It's just mad syllables, bro. I'm just like,
it's not really going nowhere. It's not really cohesive.
Cut half of them words. I guess, but I mean, I get it because that's the way he rap.
I can't agree with that per se. You know what I'm saying? Just because he's saying a lot of words, don't like if what he's saying and getting it to the point quicker than his opponent, then I get what you're saying. You know what I'm saying? But as long as he makes some sort of sense, you know, and have some type of impact with what he's saying, then I get it. But more so with this battle, it was just nasty in terms of execution. And I understand, like, everybody saying the prep for 2 weeks. It's tough because you had a battle. The first battle was two guys that had 2 weeks as well. You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, everybody that was on the right side bracket. You know what I'm saying? Like Fonz and Ace, Fonz, Ace, Easy, and Hands. It was on the same side of the bracket. You feel what I'm saying? And they had the battle tonight, Fonz and Easy. And then you had Brooklyn Hands and Ace. This shit was a struggle. It was a struggle.
And it's not all about Ace neither. Brooklyn Hands was terrible.
So I'm saying both of them was having problems. You know what I'm saying?
Funniest shit, yo. This nigga, yo, Uncle Rod, don't say this, yo. Do not say this no more, yo. Even though I get what you're saying, Uncle Rod, do not say I didn't understand nothing that he said. I didn't know what he said. It just sounds bad.
If he didn't, if he doesn't, why not say it?
Because my nigga, you a judge.
Brooklyn Hands is letting a lot of.
Hold on. Having some technical difficulties right now. Alright, go ahead, bro. What you were saying?
Alright. I feel like the culture not keeping it 1,000. Because I feel like everybody wants to jump on Rita for saying she don't understand what Brooklyn Hands was saying or whatever, right? And I feel like if you had to keep it 1,000 with everybody, I feel like that's mostly everybody. We just like what the nigga presents on stage. I think a lot of what this nigga says, most people don't get. I'm trying to understand why niggas is just picking on Rita when you got Uncle Rod right next to us saying he don't understand a fucking word.
Yeah, he be saying that a lot, yo. He be saying that shit a lot, bro. He be saying that shit a lot.
When she says it, it's a problem. Y'all niggas is being funny style. That shit's corny.
Yeah, nah, niggas
be... don't fully understand what he's saying either. Y'all just like the presence. Y'all like the delivery. But you're not going to sit here and tell me you got a whole ball-for-ball breakdown on your fucking laptop like you understood every word. Cut that shit out, yo. Y'all niggas being
and cool. Even keeping it a buck amongst us. Can we keep it a buck? Now, we know bars. We not catching everything Brooklyn Hands is saying.
It's no way. So stop trying to kill the female judge when it's another judge on the same panel saying he don't get it. Y'all niggas bugging, man. Cut that shit out.
Yeah, I definitely think that Rita catches the most flack out of everybody. And that's just, it's different reasons. One, she's a female. Let's just keep it real. Like, that's just, you know what I mean? Some people might not be as familiar with her as the other judges. So it's kind of easier to do that. But I think that some of the other critiques is a lot worse. Like, at least Rita articulates it well on what she liked and which rounds she liked it. Uncle Rod be dead flat out saying to you, I didn't know what the fuck they were saying. I didn't understand anything. So I'm going to just flip a coin and I'm going to just pick a winner. It's like, yo, my nigga, like, we not doing that, bro. Like, you better fake it till you make it, nigga. You better act like you knew what he said, nigga. Don't tell me that. What's wrong with you? Don't tell me that, bro.
Like, yo, I understand what Sam was saying. And I ain't.
Yeah, I see both sides.
You know. But with this battle, man, I oh shit, man. It was tough. It was tough. I really like this times where I watch battles, I'm able to follow everything, bro. But this was just really tough to like really just write down like what I liked and what I didn't like. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm looking at my notes right now. Like shout out to Hands, but like I enjoy Hands better in a song format or him rapping over a beat because him a cappella, you know, battling was like rough. It was rough. Yeah. I ain't gonna hold you. And I fuck with Hands, you know what I'm saying? I fuck with Math, NYB, you know, but like in a battle format, this shit was tough. Yeah. Ain't gonna lie. Like he had some shit that I kinda understood. Like the Essence magazine was good. The Sensei in my ear, you know what I'm saying? Right. The Artichoke, the P
that was fire.
Ace, you know what I mean? Pacemaker. The second round was good. I ain't gonna lie. You know what I'm saying? The second round was good. The third round was good too. I'm gonna keep it real though. Like, I don't want to be the bad guy here, but it's Ace pretty much. He's lucky that he won the battle because honestly, if you gave it a second watch, you may give the battle to Hands just off of what we was talking about earlier with me and Fat Boy about stumbling and shit like that. Like,
right?
Even though Hands was stumbling too, you feel what I'm saying?
And choking.
Yeah, and the choke too. Oh, you know what? This whole battle,
Yeah, bro, I don't know what the hell was that about. The nigga dead ass said, bro. The nigga dead ass like choked at the end, and like during the choke, nigga just said time. He like, oh, that's time? Oh, I bet. Like, that wasn't a choke. Like, no, motherfucker, you choked. Like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Right. Like, that shit don't just get fucking.
We wasn't confused. We wasn't confused at all. We know exactly what the fuck just happened. Choke. Right? And they called time, and you got lucky. But this is what I hate about the battle, and Dutch was kind of alluding to it a second ago. It's like, yo, the bad part about both of y'all niggas choking is like, all right, it's one thing if one nigga choke, and then you could go, okay. I can see where this nigga won the round. Both of y'all choke and y'all had stumbles throughout the round. It's like, fam, now you're going to make me decipher through the trash that both of y'all just did to try to pick who was better out of the trash y'all just did. That's why I just was like, I don't even give a fuck who won this battle at this point.
Man,
I don't even care now. Y'all just fucked it all the way up. It was bad, yo. It was that was ugly, man.
Who did y'all give the battle to? Who did y'all give the battle to, that battle?
Let me say this: to struggle to get a W against somebody that's choking basically every round speaks volumes. Like you barely won against somebody that choked damn near every round.
Hey, like, it doesn't matter because even one of them niggas is beating Fonz. It do not matter at all. It don't matter. Yeah. Y'all not beating Fonz like that. It's not gonna happen. Easy had three crazy rounds and he didn't. You're not gonna tell me two stumbling niggas, either one who won, is gonna get past that nigga. It's not happening. Not going for it.
I ain't gonna lie, like Ace had a strong third. You know what I'm saying? With the forfeit,
he was stumbling though.
4 inches, ran a couple yards. Nah, he had a dope Alabama scheme. You know what I'm saying? Like that was cool too. The Uncle Ross shot was interesting. I like that. I ain't gonna lie, like that shot was. That shot was potent.
What did he say? I don't remember what he said with that.
The stumbles and chokes, bro. That was just.
Yeah.
Alexa, let's go to the next battle. Alexa.
Hold on. Before you do that, I got a question. Since we cleared these two battles already, this should be funny. What's more impressive to y'all? The fact that Ace has stumbled through two battles, even though some of the material was okay? Or Rube Bando having two bad battles and still being clean and making it to the next round. Like, what's more impressive to y'all?
Jesus.
I know. For me, it's Ace because Rube Bando, as bad as he was, he had bad opponents on top of that. So it's like, all right, your opponents was trash.
At least he's making it through his material.
Right, and at least you're making it through the material. Nigga, you're literally doing one of the worst things you could do in a battle, which is stumble and choke, and you're going round by round. Like you made it all the way to the final four.
Yo, nah, B. I think that's even worse. I think that's the first band though, because like for, if you really think about it, like I bet band who had trash opponents, right? Or you know what I'm saying, whatever the case may be. East is choking and stumbling and moving on. So exactly what does that say to the quality of his opponents?
These might be two of the worst W's in battle rap history.
I told you, man, Rubando nigga be winning by safeties, B.
3-2.
Listen, Rubando gave you six bad rounds, and he won battle away from home. Make that make sense.
Yeah.
Six bad rounds, one and mind you, away from
home. And mind you now, guys like Real Sick, Kid Chaos,
yeah.
Big Hand, Easy to Block, Lou Castro are all sitting at home.
What?
That's crazy.
Can I say the last weird thing about this battle?
Yeah.
It actually, the judges had it 2-2 and it went to the fans.
Oh my God. This is exactly why this fan vote shit is some bullshit because, no, I'm going to keep it 100, B. Like, this battle should not have been that lopsided in the votes, my nigga. This is when popularity starts coming in, my nigga. Yeah. This nigga fucking, bro, this nigga Brooklyn Hands had like 700 votes, bro. Nigga Ace Amin had almost 2,000 votes. I'm like, yo, my nigga, what the fuck is going on right now, yo?
Niggas had the nerve to make it overwhelmingly Ace at that. So it's like, not only did you choke and you stumble, but we don't understand you, so we all picking Ace. We don't know what you rapping about. It just sound good, but we got Ace, my nigga. We ain't doing this. Two battles in a row. Come on, bro.
Man, Brooklyn Hands would have won that, bro. I don't
know. Yo, if he'd have made it to this next round, niggas would have been, they niggas would have lost.
Yo, let me ask y'all a question. No, real talk. All jokes aside. Y'all ready for... Pardon me. All jokes aside, no funny shit. Are y'all ready for Rubando versus Ace to open up Gnome?
No, I'm not ready, and I'm not watching it.
And
I'm waiting for the next battle. I'm not watching that, bro.
And I'm not gonna pack Ace all the way up. We seen what he did with a crowd, you know, against Snake Eyes. He didn't win, but he did all right. He did, you know what I'm saying? I'm not just gonna all the way pack him up. Like, he can't give a good performance at a Gnome. But he has to get it together, though.
Freddie, this is End of the Piano at the lowest of keys. Not the time to be shooting this nigga. No bail. Battle from last year.
I tried.
You had two bad battles where you choked and stumbled, and you in the next round. And when niggas get on him about choking and stumbling, he get the blocking niggas and get mad, and he don't want to hear it. And it's like, fam, we don't know what to tell you to do to fix it, but we know damn well you're doing it a lot. That's all we can tell you, bro.
It's a thing now.
You can't
like,
be mad
at
the fans. Like, what you want us to say?
Yo, that nigga knowledge, yo. Damn, I ain't even call this nigga math, yo. That nigga knowledge about to hear all type of... Because knowledge was the reason why the nigga they went down to the fans. Knowledge picked Ace. Knowledge picked Ace. Rita picked Brooklyn Hands.
I forgot about that.
Rita picked Brooklyn Hands. Uncle Ra flipped the coin. Tony, bro, I don't know. Tony, bro, he be just... That nigga be too intellectual for me sometimes. Like, yo, my nigga, just get
when
to the point.
He's the Brooklyn Hands of voters.
He the Brooklyn Hands judges, of the judges. He the Lauryn Hill of judges.
No.
Everything.
Tony, bro, is the Lauryn Hill of judges, yo. Yo.
Oh, man.
Crazy, man. It's crazy.
Then, Knowledge, bro, you about to get kicked off my expert opinion.
Oh, you saying that they're gonna vacate his barber chair? Like,
I'm about to take his spot.
Yo, Ben, you were
fizz over. They about to quarantine that shit. Over, don't sit here.
Yo, I feel yo, damn, yo, that's just a lot, yo. That's just a lot. Well,
let's give our winners real quick so we can move on.
Oh, Brooklyn has won.
I had no goddamn winner. We lost.
Ain't no winners here.
We lost.
We lost two in a row.
I'm rolling. I'm buying. I'm not picking the winner if y'all not. We all lost.
We all lost, bro.
What you going to explain how one nigga won? How?
You right. Y'all ain't gonna pack me
already. It don't matter.
All right, yo. Moving along, yo. We had the Mad King, The Rock, versus Big Lou How we, that battle was fire, yo. I ain't gonna hold you. That battle, like, it brought, like, I was, after the last two battles before this one, yo, I was just in such a disarray, bro. I felt like I was in a Twilight Zone, my nigga. Like, what the fuck is going on? But that battle brought me back to reality. Fire battle overall, yo.
Fire battle overall. It was a good back four. It was a good back
four. Let me say this, yo. Luke Castro's charisma, my nigga, through the roof, yo. Like,
facts.
That nigga's a star.
I had some issues though. Like, I think I think the 2 weeks prep, you could tell, kind of bothered him because, you know what I'm saying, he was kind of relying on shit that hit in the first round. Like, the he brought the, you know, how he had to fucking nailed it. He brought like some gnarly dude type shit. That shit wasn't it. Like, it was like he was trying
to take the gnarly dude. He had the up yours, pal.
Yeah, up yours, pal. Like, that shit just wasn't hitting. Like, that shit was bad. And yeah, but some of this shit, like, I definitely think Lou is here to stay. He's definitely. The end of his third.
Yo, I'm gonna get straight to the point. For me, I'm gonna get straight to the point. Again, Lou Castro, you definitely have arrived, my nigga. The fans will be looking forward to your next battle. But this battle breaks down to one thing. And the third, he couldn't get to a point where it made it debatable, because I felt like he needed that third, and that would have saved him. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I feel like you can make a case for it to be Lou Castro winning the first and Jay winning the second. And that third, Jay had another good round, and Lou, he couldn't match it to make it debatable. And I think we all knew when it went to the judges, like, there's no way they picking Lou, bro.
Right.
He fucked up his third. He couldn't – he just didn't have it. He ran out of gas at the end, bro.
What did you call it at the end? Was it a choke freestyle? Was it – did he get through his shit, but it was sloppy?
It was cut, yeah. It was more like it was just, like, he forgot his material, and he started, like, just trying to freestyle it back to where he could get it back on track, it felt like. Mm. And it didn't work, bro. Ran out of steam, like, I don't know. The 2 weeks prep might have hurt real bad, man.
Yeah, as far as with his creativeness and all that, you feel me? He just kind of tried to do what he did in the first round over again. It just didn't hit again. He wasn't creative enough. But he definitely still had moments. You know what I'm saying? He came out of this tournament with quotables and new slogans. The whip the pot. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's here to stay for sure. You definitely going to see Lou Castro getting some good plates in the future. Jada Nightwing was good again, man. Three more good rounds. I don't remember no stumbles or chokes. Possibly chokes or anything. He looked like he got through it. How do y'all feel about the judges saying that he kind of dumbed it down? Do y'all think he dumbed it down this round?
I didn't, no, yo.
I didn't.
Yo, it was shit that he was saying. I'm not even going to hold you. I thought I caught it. And then A-Ward was, like, retweeting some of the bars and shit. Like, he was tweeting. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, shit. I didn't even catch the double entendre on that. Like, he had a lot of double entendres that was, like, you thought it meant one thing. And then when you write it out, you're like, oh, nah, this nigga is wilding. Like, the passive bar, the passive shit he said, the whole church thing, that was crazy, my nigga. Like, I don't know. Like, Jada Nightwing, he might have the best wordplay in the tournament.
Yeah, he's nice.
Like, hey.
I don't think that.
He had a he bro, hit
he's
a
saying shit, bro, that nobody else is saying. Like, Fonz is the best puncher.
That nigga Fonz.
Fonz is the best puncher, though, bro. He doesn't have the best wordplay, my nigga. He just punches the best.
Overall rapping ability right now, I gotta give it to Jada Nightwing. And let me say
nigga,
this
he's
first.
Saying some
why y'all
shit.
Niggas talking about Lou Castro like he died or something? Like, y'all niggas giving eulogies and shit like that.
Hell
like,
no,
you know,
he didn't die.
Lou Castro was a good person. He did good. You know,
he went crazy. He didn't do good. He went crazy.
He's somebody's son.
Never that. I think even Lou know that he could have did better, though. I think he tweeted it out that this wasn't the best me. You feel me? And it's like, that's kind of why I went with that angle.
Hey, look, I told y'all, man, before, this was Greg Pop versus Mike D'Antoni. You know what I'm saying? All that run and gun shit was cool. He started off strong in the first round.
Yeah.
First round of Castro. You know what I'm saying? He did his thing in the first. Yeah, that was his best round. But Pop slowed the pace down on the offense, turned it to a half court set.
It's like basketball.
They like basketball. Like, niggas got tired out.
How do y'all feel? That's a great analogy. How do y'all feel about his third? He and him not being able to finish his third.
Jaden Nightwing?
Yeah.
Was that his third or his second?
That was his third.
Second, wasn't it?
No, that was his third.
Oh, Jaden Nightwing tried to be smooth and try to, you know, get through it. But nigga P was like, nah, nigga, time.
Right.
We not doing that.
Shout out to Vlad at Let's Talk Battle Rap. I think he put out a tweet where he said, maybe it's good that he got time because who knows if that twerk shit would have hit or not. We have never really seen Jay do some shit like that. So that could have hurt his round. You feel me? So it's like, I don't know. We didn't see it.
They should have let him finish it off, y'all.
He picked the worst possible time to do that shit. It's no crowd. You don't know right. if it's going to get any reaction from the few people that's in the room. And to me, I'm like, dog, I'm sitting there saying to myself, now, why would the fuck with Pete or URL or whoever the fuck idea was to stop that shit? Why would you do that, bro? We all heard 30, 40 strap-ins by now. Why would you cut that? Why don't you just wait till that last bar? It ain't going to hurt. It's the third round. The battle is about over. Mm-hmm. Why would you stop that right there like that? Why would you do that? You know what this is right here.
Yeah.
So I just felt like that was kind of fucked up.
He said on the show, though. He said, yo, I'm doing a hard time. Like, I'm calling time on niggas. But it's a way to call time. Like, I think Terror does a good job at that. Like, he waits until the bar is over, and then he goes time before you even get to that next bar, if you over the time limit. You know what I'm saying? It's weird when you do that shit in the middle of a nigga talking and all that. Like,
but Your Honor's first round was like 3.5 minutes. Like, they ain't timing everybody, though. Your Honor's first round was long as fuck.
You let him rap. Let him rap after the fact, and then you cut it again before he can finish it. Like, what was the point of letting him rap again if you're gonna cut it again?
Yeah, that's a fact.
That don't make sense to me.
That's a fact.
Nah, he's like, he said time first, and then I guess he's like, Jaden Nightwing was like, I'm gonna try to do it. I'm gonna try to do it again. See if he let me rap.
And he was like, nah,
bro. Like, I just told you time, bro.
Yo, if you listen. He said, you can hear him say in the background, I'm going to give you 10 seconds.
10 seconends is not enough time, yo. Yo, 10 seconds is not enough time, bro. No, actually, no. In battle rap,
it would have been.
Battle rap time, 10 seconds. He counted the 10 seconds while he was talking. That's what happened. Yo, that's
give him a millimeter of a second.
Yo.
He said, go ahead. Time.
Yo, let me ask y'all a question, yo. Is Twerk a vet for him to be on Rookies versus Vets?
Nigga, it's Twerk. They gonna let that nigga do whatever the fuck.
Yeah. You know what? Yo, Fat Boy said it, man. I mean,
Twerk, bro. He has a solid 3 years of main stage battle. I think it's a little early to call him a vet, but I think it fits on the card per se. If that makes sense.
Yeah,
they gave him the same treatment Clips get is the same treatment that they give this.
Is Geechee Gotti a vet?
Geechee gotta be a vet. It's weird because it's like. Geechee came in after Twerk, but he a vet, bro.
And he came in at the same time, bro.
Geechee's more of a vet. I agree.
They got vet resumes.
He's not considered a vet. Yeah. There's no way he's not a vet at this point.
So, did we all have Jaden Nightwing winning that battle?
Yeah, we did. I did at least. I can't speak for y'all.
Yeah, I gave him the second and third. I gave Lou the first clear, though.
Yeah.
I got it right now, Jaden Nightwing. I want to see it again. I'm going to watch it again after this, man. I'm going to watch it again.
Get upset about Rue Bando, and Rue Bando is about to go to the fucking finals, bro. Unknown.
Yo, let's...
Damn.
All right, let's bring some of the fans in, man. Let's talk to the people. Let's see what the people got to say about this
Big Low
and all that. You want to bring up Big Low? We was talking about Big Low earlier today, right? Let's bring up Low. Yo, Big Low. You gotta unmute yourself, sis. Say, nigga, I ain't come up here to talk to y'all.
This nigga Rue Bando gonna win the 25K. He gonna go back to the home team and build a whole fucking We Go Hard gymnasium for the squad.
That's a fact.
What's the deal?
Oh, we got the low JT in the building.
JT gang.
What up, bro? What's good, Slime?
Yo, hi,
we chilling. Yo, Low, we were talking earlier, yo. Yo, you gotta reference us to this Michigan shit, yo. What the fuck was your honor talking about? With the
I
whole
don't know
fact
what the fuck your honor was talking about. I don't think
nobody knew what Your Honor was talking about. But I was lit that he brought up the 5'5", though. I ain't gonna lie.
No.
And, well, and explained it terribly.
I don't know what the fuck he's talking about. I don't know how it was even relevant.
Yo,
he might have said Juwan Howard first. Like, are you tripping?
Yo, he had a chance that, yo, the ball could have been fired, though. It could have led up to something crazy at the end, but that nigga just was doing whatever he wanted to do, my nigga. Like, he was on some other
type. Mr. Wavy effect.
That was definitely the Mr. Wavy effect. I'm not going to hold you.
He was rapping. He was real loud and aggressive. I was like, damn, on mute, this nigga's fire.
On mute, this nigga's fire.
If you turn that volume down, you just be like, damn, he's spitting some shit. I just know it. You turn it up like, what the fuck?
Yo, Lo, what was your thoughts on Brooklyn Hill versus Lauren Hands? Did you like that battle? Did you fuck with that?
Yeah, I watched it.
Versus Ace, I mean.
I just feel like the stumbling and shit, I don't really care for all of that. Like, it's 2 minutes. It's 2 minutes. Come on now. It's no crowd, like, what's the problem?
I don't know, man.
Especially after the first battle being so good, it's just like, come on now.
Well, speaking of the first battle, who you had winning Easy to Block Fapton versus because this nigga Fat Boy got fucking one of them diseases where you can't remember shit, and he all of a sudden he telling us some shit that never happened.
This nigga lying to you, but go ahead.
Who was the first? Who did he battle?
Easy to Block Captain versus Fonz.
Oh, I had Fonz in that battle.
Exactly. Which round did you have him winning?
Didn't Easy win the fan vote? Easy won the fan vote.
Yeah.
Yep. I don't know, because it seemed like when they was rapping, like when I was looking in the comments and stuff, it seemed like everybody was going for Fonz, and then I was real surprised to see that he won the...
That's because everybody vote for both of them. I voted for both of them. Who going to stop me from voting for both?
Yeah, I did. On one of them battles, for sure, I voted for both of them.
Both of them was fire.
I still don't know how to vote. That shit don't stay on the screen long enough to vote. Like,
they give us enough time, though.
In the beginning, I feel like, now, because it gets it stay up there forever.
It's just like every other comment. You see it for a quick second, and the other shit just start popping up.
Please get my nigga Q up here, bro. I need to hear what this nigga's saying, dog.
Q about
to lie.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Here we go.
Let's keep it up.
Q, you on right now. What do you have to say?
What's good, man? What's good, fam?
What's going on, Q? The Mad King one. Talk to us.
Uh-huh. So wait, before I even start, are we on real nigga time?
We always are, son. Hey, spit your narrative. Let's get it.
Spit your narrative. It's the science, I'm feeling baby.
Come on, man. Niggas gotta start paying attention, bro. We got stars in the making right here, dog. That nigga, Easy was cool, but you're not good enough yet, man.
Salute. He was cooking.
He was straight though, it wasn't bad. He was straight.
Nah, he wasn't bad.
I hear all y'all. Mute this nigga Q because he's wilding. I thought he was talking about my man. Next caller, my nigga.
Come on, Fat Boy. This new era, man. We on real nigga time all the time, bro. We gotta keep it the stack. Jay the Nightwing, aka. Exact, bro. It's just levels, bro. It's just levels, man. As far as that whole, cropping out the best of the best. Unfortunately, you know, Ace and Brooklyn Hands, whatever the fuck they was on, they was kind of bullshitting. But when you look at Fonz, you look at Jay the Nightwing, you look at these are niggas that's going to be the stars in the future, bro.
I agree.
This is what I want to say. When they drop this battle on the app, right, I'm not even getting on Twitter that day. Because if I start seeing everybody say Easy One, I'm a wild fuck out. I don't want to hear that shit. Don't come back and tell Fat Boy nothing, because I don't want to hear that shit.
But hold on, Fat Boy. In the comments, and I seen you too, Ben. In the comments, they capped out at 1K, both of them, when they was voting. So it was dead tie. And then Ben put up another vote. Ben put up another joint that was like, yo, I think Easy got or something like that. And I didn't say that.
Don't try to say here, though. Yeah. Oh, boy, yo. This nigga Q began. This nigga Q always trying to
1K. Like it was stopped at 1K.
No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. How cap that 1K?
Pack that shit.
I seen it at 2 later in the day, but originally it stopped at 1K, and I was like, oh, I guess we can't vote on it no more. It stopped right there, and then back another one.
Here's the thing, right? You looking at it on your phone, right? You watching the battles on your phone. I'm watching it on my Mac. You can see past 1K. You can see it says 1,700, 1,800, 1,900, 2,000, 2,100. You can actually see the numbers on your computer. Get your, you know what I mean? I know you got a raise in all that. 2 raises, easy to block cap.
Can somebody else confirm this, please?
I seen it on the okay. But I couldn't see it go like 1.1, 1.2.
Because y'all watching on your phone. When you watch on the computer, you can actually see the numbers. Now, don't sit here, Q, and try to be making up shit that I said easy one. I never said that, bro. Never said that, bro. I never said that.
What I'm going to say is, the better man won, dog. We can't be upset.
That's not what happened, bro.
Battle of the night, either way. Shout out to them.
Salute the funds. I'm always going to get that nigga's credit. He deserve it, yo. He one of the niggas.
Super now, both of them dudes did the numbers. You know what I'm saying? Both of them. Both Barnes and Easy. I think both of them are stars.
He smacked the shit out of his chest. I was just waiting for Easy to respond. Like, I thought that it was going to be equal smacks. Like, I thought he was going to smack him back. I was like,
no, it was like a shoulder check.
Yeah,
like I don't think it was a slap.
It was loud. I was like, damn.
Yo, she said Ric Flair chopped this shit.
That Ace on me bump was like fucking love tap.
Snake Eyes was in the comment here like, yo, I ain't never, Ace didn't bump me that hard. Like,
that's the fuck he did, my nigga. That's the fuck he did.
Can I just say this real quick, y'all? Can we?
No, don't lie, yo. Go ahead.
I'm not gonna lie. I just wanna, and salute to you, Bigelow. I just wanna say something. Can we get Big Lou the fuck out of here? You not it, Chief. Like,
nah. All right.
Thank you, yo.
Yeah, I muted him. Mute that nigga. He muted. You.
Next offense, you out of here, son. You getting the boot,
man. Pack Q up now. He couldn't wait, yo. He couldn't wait to get that off, yo. He couldn't wait, yo. Mute Q, yo.
Yeah, Sam, we let you get that pass.
Yo, Lo, you want to say anything else, yo, before we bring somebody else on? Lo? Hello? Yo? Oh, shit, what the hell going on right now? Oh, what happened, man? That just blew my shit. Hold on, yo.
No, hey, that was the one off.
Yo, hello?
Already.
Yo, y'all can hear me?
27.
Yo, y'all can hear me? Mm-hmm. Oh, my fucking, I had a blackout in my house. All the power shut off. Oh, shit.
We're gonna talk about it in the rundown, Fat Boy, at the end.
All right. I hear nothing.
It's the next tournament.
Yo, okay. I didn't hear nothing that y'all said. I'm not gonna hold you because my whole shit just shut down while we was talking.
Nigga, pay your fucking light bill. You gotta stop paying out all these goddamn. Yeah. This nigga is paying out all these bets he losing, and now his light's gone. He's gonna come on here and lie talking about the power went out. Stop lying, my nigga.
Yo, I got too much shit stop plugged lying, in, yo. Bro. That's why. Fucking with y'all niggas, man. Hey.
We're not even recording no more.
Oh, yeah.
Nah, we still record. We still record. It's gonna be a
shortage of shit out.
It's gonna be a large blank though. Like
we don't gotta cut Q out now.
Nah, after Q got cut out, right after that, I don't know what the fuck happened. Like some other shit happened, right? I don't know what the fuck going on. But
back live though.
Yeah, we back live with it. Lo, we gonna holler at you, sis. You already know.
Love, Lo.
Appreciate you.
Let's bring up the homie and all that. You know what I mean? He always pull up on us and shit, so always like talking to my guy. My guy, Don Marino. Que lo que? Don.
Good guy, Don. What's up, man?
Yo, what's good with y'all, man? Y'all feeling?
What's good?
We chilling, man. Good. You watched the tournament yesterday? You said, fuck this shit.
Yeah. Nah, I was like, yeah, fuck this tournament. Man. I'm not watching this.
Nah. Hey, Don, keep it funky, yo. You had Easy 3-0, right?
Against who?
Nobody had Fonz. Easy 3-0, bro.
I give Easy the first. Oh, and then I get Fonz the second and third.
Pack this nigga up. Next.
Nope. Talk that shit down.
You can't. I told Easy, bro. I said, Easy, you can't do all three rounds of like struggle bars, bro. It's not gonna work. It worked against me. That's what people already put that narrative. But against Fonz, you're gonna have to do more, bro. Cause Fonz is different, bro. His punching is so crazy.
Yeah, his material was always fire. I'll super fuck with it.
Did you take Easy's advice and go in the kitchen and rinse it off?
Bro, when he said it, I laughed. That's it. We could have did that.
Shout out that's to funny Easy. Man.
So, which battle did you like better, the first one or the last
one? Nah, the first, Fonz and Easy was crazy, man. But, like, Fonz is so dangerous, bro. Like, Fonz wrote his third, like, that Thursday night, bro. And, wow. And like, because he had called me, he was like, yo, okay, he already showed me his first two. He called me, like, bro, I just finished my third. I was like, bro, it's Thursday, 11 at night, man. Like, you got a battle in 2 days. And he goes, just tell me what you think. He spent that third, and I was like, bro, you just came up with this shit right now? He was like, yeah. I said, oh, man. Like,
how long did it take him to write the third?
Bro, he wrote it that day.
Damn, I hate all of it.
That's crazy. So, like, he's good at memorization. This tournament style for him is fit, bro. And I thought his third round was his best round. Gonna be probably his second, but his third was one of the one of his better rounds too.
I'm gonna say it right now. When they get to doing this versus Vets, if they pick anybody other than Av, I swear to God, bro, people going to go crazy. Yeah, for Fonz, they give him anybody other than Av, people gonna lose their shit. You might could throw Rum Nitty up there, but yeah. I don't know, dog. They're gonna be pissed Don. Have you pick somebody not one of them?
Have you got that call for Rookies versus Vets, Don?
Yeah, they gave me two options. They gave me two choices, and I end up going with the one I feel like was a better move for me.
We know one of those options was the stereotypical Hispanic Latino matchup. Was
no, believe it or not, it wasn't. Man, me and Cortez. Be quick, because the thing with that battle, bro, I feel like that battle could happen anytime and it'll be anywhere, like, you know what I'm saying? And then to waste it on a rookie versus Vets, well, just give me a different vet, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
I wonder if I could say who they offered me, man. I don't know if I would get in trouble for that shit.
Could you tell us the person you didn't pick? That'd give us an idea of the level of competition. All right.
I didn't pick Rum Nitty.
Okay.
So is that okay? The other one is I'm not gonna say he's I'm not gonna like be like who's better, whatever. That he really clearly was the better batter, especially stock wise. But like, I feel like for me, after coming off the Easy battle, I need to get back on like a win streak type shit. You feel me? And let's be real, like, I'm not the most liked cat in URL. So like, me battling the most loved guy on Rookie versus Vets is not gonna help me.
What do you think you have to change, Don, in order to get the fans to more relate to you?
Bro, I'm gonna be honest with you, bro. It's like not caring what the fans think anymore, bro. Like, I think that's what's been bothering me. Like, every battle, like, okay, Don needs Mexican bars, so I stopped doing them. Oh, Don, why you didn't do them? Or Don's does this, Don do that. And it's like, man, I gotta just do what got me here, and whatever got me, I just gotta make that better. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
A lot of the fan talk is us really just talking shit, bro. I don't mean specifically us, but I mean the fans in general. Like, we just talking shit. We do love this culture, so we voicing what we see. We only fans, so we don't really fucking know, which leads to my question. What are your NWX members saying to you after that battle?
Nah, they were like, bro, why didn't you do Mexican bars? Like, you did, you know what I'm saying? And I was like, bro, people say they didn't want to hear him. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're like, who cares? Like, you're like, and then after the battle, like, people were tagging me, like, you know, obviously I got my own fans that are gonna say I got robbed. You know what I'm saying? That's how it all works. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They were like, yo, why you didn't do Mexican bars, or why you didn't do sound effects, or why you didn't do this? You know what I'm saying? It was like, well, y'all motherfuckers say y'all didn't want to hear him. You know what I'm saying? Like, so
yeah. So, like, and you know what's crazy? What's crazy you saying that is they saying don't do Mexican bars, but when Easy won, they told him go back to where he normally do. Don't try to do the punches in it. So they made him go back to his original shit and they told you to go away. That's why I was like, yo, do what you think works best. Don't listen to the fans, bro. You got to take some of that criticism, but not to heart all the way. Like, that shit is going to fuck you up. It's going to fuck you up. You can't win. And the funny thing, you're not going to win either way. No matter which way you do it, they're going to have some criticisms. Never forget that shit.
Yeah, nah, definitely. Because DNA started calling me like, bro, why the fuck you didn't? Because I had Mexican bars going in the round. And going into the battle, I was just right in the moment of the battle, I was like, you know what, I'm gonna just take him out. I know he's gonna say something about him, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And the Mexican bars I had were crazy, man. I forgot what it was. It was some shit like, I said I'll rob you for your social, bring the eagle through, ain't the eagle truce. So when the dust settles, they get a little ahead. Beetlejuice, Mexican bars. My Theo had to switch his ID. He had to change it, brother. Used to call me from the strangest numbers, but couldn't lock it in my phone because I didn't know what name to save it under. Like, I had some shit like that. Like, I was going to put it in there.
Stick with what got you here, bro.
But, like, I switched it up. So I was like, fuck it. So, and I ended up freestyling some shit in a second, I think.
It also sounded like, I remember you in the face-off, you kind of had a round placement. You said you were going to use Mexican bars first, talk pain second, and get personal third, but it seemed like you switched it up once the battle started.
Yeah, you know what's crazy? My second round, my second round was originally my first round, and my first round was my third, and my second, I had 2 second rounds. Like, I had I had an extra round just of, like, I had a round of a minute, and I had an extra round on me that was like a minute 10, and I was going to freestyle the rest of it if I felt like I was winning the third, like, if I was, like, going into the third, like, okay, I got this, I could just rebuttal it, but, I end up switching my shit because I feel like the first with the Hurricane Dew angle, I wanted to get him like upset, like uncomfortable. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And then and his second, I'm gonna mean personally me, but I think I think bar wise I won that second. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know people gotta be like, nah, but like, because after the battle, I talked to the two judges, like, oh yeah, Don, you had the better bars, but we just like his energy. And I was like, oh, okay. So you know what I'm saying? So I was like, all right, so. But it was, you know, shout out to Easy, man. He did good. You know, I think he did real good against Fonz. Like, that first round was dope, but
yeah,
Fonz is too much, bro.
I hate to jump the gun, but I'm going to assume that it's going to end up Fonz Jaden Nightwing. Who do you like in that battle?
That's hard, bro, because I'm going to lie. Like, those two of my guys, for real. Like, I talked to Jay last night. He hit me up, and I talked to Fonz, like before I got jumped in here, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Right.
And I talk to them all the time. Like, they on some type of shit, like, after they finish a round, they call me to hear, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah. Like, it's so weird, man, because, like, I heard earlier y'all say, I think Jay got the best wordplay. I don't think so. I think Fonz got the better wordplay.
Yeah, that's what, like, I think.
Okay.
Like, bro, he told his man, go back to jail and I'm fucking your boo. In the house, quarantine style, nothing to do. That's crazy, bro.
That's crazy, bro.
I was like, yo, why the fuck you didn't get that to me when I was battling Easy, bro? What's wrong with you? why you sent me in there like that, bro? What's going on?
I'll go ahead, Don.
Nah, he got the better wordplay, man. Jay just got that presence, bro. Like, Jay doesn't have to do a punch to get reactions. Like, I remember when me and him battled, he was like, you're like, I don't care if you're getting in your bag because you're getting in this one. And it shook the building. And that's not a punch. Yeah. You know, that's just him, just his presence. And so, like, because with Jay, bro,
acting well, you know what I'm saying?
Like, with me and Jay, if you really watch that battle, I'm out punching him. I'm literally out punching him. But his presence is like, and the way his demeanor is, it makes it look like I'm trying so hard. So, like, it's going to be a hard battle to call, man. But realistically, Fonz got the advantage because Jay's not good with the prep time. They got 2 weeks right after that. They literally have like 2 weeks to go into Nome.
Right.
I think Jaden Nightwing is, you're right, it's not a lot of punches. It's just very witty lines that when you do a good delivery of it, it sells very well. And like you said, the presence in the room, the size advantage he has over opponents, it just hit different when he give it up.
He ended his third like that against Sick too, where he was like, you know, I'm gonna kill you, but they're gonna have to remind me. Like, that's not even really a punchline or something. It's just, you know, it's the way he sells it, the way he projects it.
When you know how to rap really well, you know what I'm saying? Like, simple things,
you know, mm-hmm. people try to measure, you know, punches and wordplay. Sometimes mm-hmm. the simplest thing, when you know how to rap, so effective because it makes it seem like you're doing it effortlessly, you know what I'm saying? And that's what Jaden Nightwing does to me, you know, pause. Like,
that's a fact.
Yo, let me ask y'all a question, yo. Let me ask y'all a question, B. What's up? How y'all feel about, like, niggas in the... It's supposed to be, like, a small room with nobody going... And you hear certain niggas going wild crazy for certain people. Did that kind of, like, blow y'all shit a little bit?
I personally like it. I'm going to tell you why. I like it right now. Just right now. I wanted to just be no sound. Just let these niggas rap. But for this tournament, the reason I like it is because... We haven't had a crowd for a battle in a long time. And I kind of like the feel of the crowd interacting with what's going on in front of them during the battle. It's not taken away from me. I know Tom Bro had an issue with it. He was telling them to chill the fuck out after that first battle. But I fuck with it, bro. I like that energy in the back. You can feel it in the room. So it kind of matches hearing it in the background. Like, they not gassing. I can tell you that. That's why I'm cool with it. I don't feel like they're gassing.
Don, I wish they had that because, like, when I battled Easy, it was only, like, other than the battlers, it was probably, like, 10 people there, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And and there were, you know what I'm saying, but this one, I heard it was, like, 25.
25 people in there?
That's what I heard.
But it's just the same thing as the roof. The first few battles we watched on the look like it was 3 or 4 people up there, and this the last battle we watched, it was like, yo, it was mad standing in the background. So it's like, as the events get more popular, the battles are showing up and shit. They can start bringing people. So, I mean, like I said, it wasn't gas. I thought it was all warranted reaction, so I'm cool with the shit. What y'all think?
Yeah, I'm cool with it. I wanted to ask Don about this before we get into your matchup Saturday. How did you feel about the Big Hand Brooklyn Hands battle? Do you think they got it right, or do you think
it was Big Hand,
you should be battling Brooklyn Hands?
Oh, thank God. Yeah, man. Just nah, but on the building, I really did thought Big Hand won. Like, bro, it's crazy. I'm not even gonna use this in the battle, but like, all right. So basically, the way it is, one person has to stand. Like, let's say, like, okay, me Easy about the battle, right? Mm-hmm. Easy stands on one corner. I have to go behind the curtain. There's a curtain. I have to go behind the corner and stand in the other curtain. I mean, behind the other corner. And they count to three. When they get to three, we walk in and we start rapping, right? So there's a curtain there. Like, where you see Jay Black and Dita Hennyman, there's a curtain there. So I'm behind. I'm you know, Brooklyn Hand and Big Hand battle before me. So I'm getting ready. So I'm behind the... So I have to go behind the curtain. So I'm behind the curtain with Big Hand. And when they're doing the judgment, you can't hear nothing. You feel me? Like, you can't hear what the judges are saying. Like, you just have to only hear what Jay Black be like, oh, you know, this person won, right? But we could pull out our phones and, like, put our headphones on and hear, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, Big Hand, I remember Big Hand was up, too. So, like, yo, Don, I'm up, too, bro. I got this. And I really felt like he won in the building. Like, in the building, I felt like he won. And then when the judges, when it was, like, 2-1, he was like, oh, shit. And when it was tied, bro, like, he turned off his phone. He like, bro, I'm going to lose, bro. I already know. And then he lost, and I could feel, I felt like his whole energy just like I was about to hand him a napkin, bro. I thought he was gonna cry. You know what I'm saying? like that's how bad, bro. Like, bro, that whole day, you know, after I lost to Easy, I wasn't like on like his type of time he was, but like I was also like, yo, Don, you want to do the wild card? I was like, fuck no, man, I ain't coming back for the losers card. You know what I'm saying? Like, So, like, in the building, I did think Big Hand did win. But on footage, I kind of got Brooklyn Hands. But at the same time, bro, it was like that's Big Hand's fault, man. Like I feel like he left it too debatable either way. So, it's like, it's not like we can't all clearly say that Big Hand clearly beat him, like, 2 clear rounds. You know what I'm saying? Like it's just there's a little debate there. So, it's one of those things, man, that I feel him. But at the same time, it's kind of like, bro, like, You had it in the bag. If you would have had, you know, maybe probably more better material or something.
Yeah,
but I'm gonna talk to Big Hand about that though.
Okay,
niggas definitely want to see that. Right? Rookies versus vets, man. I mean, that's been a big discussion. Smack even said like, yo, right after this tournament, we getting right into rookies versus vets. After that, I'm pretty sure you got the call. I agree with you, bro. I don't want to see you versus Cortez. You know what I mean? Like, all this got both Spanish, so it's a good nah. We're not doing that, my nigga. I don't want to see that battle. So salute to you for saying that. Give me five. No, not even five. Give me three names that you want to see in Rookies versus Vets.
That's like I said. They offered me two names. One of them was Rum Nitty. I called him out when I battled past, and Rum like jumped on the stage, and yeah, you know, there's even interviews with Rum Nitty say he wanted to battle me just because he fucks with that dude. But I turned that down. This Saturday, man, my first round, I'm gonna tell you the name that I throw out there. That's who I'm gonna battle. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Or it's already like I think he already said yeah. I already said yeah, and everything's agreed. But the other names I'm gonna be honest, bro. I want to battle Iron Solomon. That's like one of my dream battles right there. So I would say Iron Solomon.
Mm-hmm.
I would love to battle. I'm not sure if he's a vet now, but I would like to run it back with Chess. Like even though I won the first one, I want to see like what happens if he took it serious. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. On URL too.
Yeah. So I would say Iron Chess and Tay Rock.
Iron okay. Chess and Rock. Yeah. Okay. All right. I ain't mad at those battles at all. Freddie, we got one more question before we let Don go.
Nah, I think we covered everything with Don, man. Good luck this Saturday against Big Hand.
Yes, sir. Because you already know if you get cooked, we gonna tell you about it.
Yeah, nah, I'm fucking with this you. This one, bro. I'm telling you, I'm just back to like, I'm just doing like, what I want to do now, man. Like,
right?
I listen to these fans long enough, and like, you can't please these motherfuckers for shit.
Nah, that's a fact.
Like,
You can't be a default. You know what I'm saying? You gotta do you. You know what I'm saying? Don't be a default.
Yo, let me ask y'all, who y'all got out of this Bad News and Jay Cruz?
I didn't even know who was battling. Damn.
Yeah, they're the other matchup.
Because you remember
Kruger. Kruger.
Mm-hmm. I'm rolling with Kruger.
And y'all got twerk over Swamp.
We're gonna get into that. We got another episode to get into that, but
it's not.
I don't think it's gonna go the way niggas think it is, bro. I'm just being honest.
Oh man, I'll be there. I, I'm always tuned in, bro. I sneak in here and listen to y'all shit, man. Like, but the other chat room they be killing me, so it's the only place I'm coming in here.
You know, as soon as I see you pop up, man, you
always definitely about to do another show.
Yeah,
we can hear you, man.
All right. I got one question for Don. I'm going to put you right on the spot, bro. It's a lot of controversy. Uncle Rob, Rita, they both saying it. I don't understand what Brooklyn Hands is saying. Do you understand, as a rapper, do you understand what Brooklyn Hands is talking about?
Yeah. I think Brooklyn Hands be Ace.
Talk about it.
Wow. I had, like, bro, listen, I'm gonna be honest with you, like, if I had to battle Brooklyn Hands, the only concern I had was just the whole, like, believability. He's going to stand over me. Like, material-wise, I was like, man, I'm gonna outbar him. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But against Ace, I was really listening to what he was saying. I'm catching it. But, like, the way he punches or his style of writing is, like, really, like...
It's layered.
Believe it or not, he's scheming. Like, if he's talking about, like, a chair... He's like, I'm not going to recline in this situation. Back to what, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But he does it in a weird way. Like, so like, after watching, I'm like, yo, Brooklyn Hands just be Ace. And
I think the fans got so custom, yo, to hearing the fucking default that niggas don't even want to open their ears to anything different anyway. You know what I'm saying? Like, I agree that like this nigga do need to sometimes dumb it down. But at the same time, how could you really tell a nigga to dumb down his material?
But you know what's crazy? I think when I'm not saying he dumbed this down, but when he says things like what he said, I'll throw the dog at the frisbee. Mm-hmm. Like that, people were like clown him for that almost. Like, oh, what the fuck does that mean? But like, y'all caught it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But when he's intricate, when he's doing whatever style he's doing, y'all complaining. So it is, again, man. But like I said, listening this Saturday, he had some shit, bro. Like I remember I thought he clearly won the third. Like. Mm-hmm. I thought it wasn't up for debate, but yeah, what do I know? You know what I'm saying? I'm about just like his ass.
Nah, dead ass. Yo, Don, yo, we appreciate you pulling up, bro. You know, you always show love to the chat, so we're gonna definitely keep you, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Keep you in rotation and shit like man. That,
y'all
man.
Y'all boys take care, man.
You already know.
Sure, sure, you down.
Yep. That was Don Marino, Mexican bars. It's my guy. yeah, yo, but we gonna get another show going. I don't know. We gonna take a break, y'all. We gotta take a break actually, cause I gotta handle something real quick, and I gotta do another. I gotta do another show in like a half hour for Let's Talk Battle Rap on Caffeine.
Fact. Yeah, we could definitely take a break. Everything we're gonna talk about probably in the next episode. We got
You know these fat niggas gotta eat, man. You know the fat niggas. You know they. I'm pretty sure both them niggas is hungry. So
yeah, I already was doing like a taste test during the interview. You know, pause. Whoa. So I had a bowl in front of me, bro. Like there was some good shit here, son. So you know, I was ready. You know, getting my snack on. I don't know. I might have bled through a microphone. Probably heard me, you know, what I mean, munching and shit like that. You know.
Nah, you good,
fat boys? Your mic high, yo? Are you good, yo? Do we need to do some sound check before we go back on?
Yo, why niggas always coming after me, bro? Why it's always me,
my nigga? Because, my nigga, like, you want to be getting all this extra. My nigga, just use your phone like everybody else. We hear everybody else clear. No, you want to go buy the fucking T2000 headphones and all that. My nigga, like, come on, man.
I'm on the phone. I've been on the phone the whole show.
For real?
With the headphones?
No, my phone, my regular phone, the way we always did it. I'm back. I've been on my phone the whole time.
So what happened to the headphones?
I took it off. It's like within like 2 or 3 minutes I was doing it. I just was like, I can't hear me talking. So something, I don't want it to sound fucked up. We'll fuck around with it another time. Like I try to get it going later.
He got the Martin. What's up? Headphones.
Chill. Damn.
What's up?
Yo, we supposed to be brothers.
Oh,
shit.
We supposed to be brothers. All right. So, yo, I'm about to go. Figure some shit out, you know what I mean, in the crib or whatever, because I don't know what the hell going on in here.
Somebody we got a lot of shit to talk about, though. We got to get another episode in later, man.
Yeah, yeah, we got a lot to talk about. We got to talk about all these announcements, next week's battles, all that shit. So we're going to definitely... Fat boy, you on vacation now, so ain't no excuse.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
They just gonna keep throwing me out there, yo. I'm out, man. Y'all niggas do what y'all do. I'll be back.
All right, y'all. New Era Podcast. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe to the channel. We out of here the same way we got here. I'll let us one.
It ain't nothing to show a nigga love, nigga. Ain't nothing wrong with that, man.